But it is safe. So now the people are starting working with 3.8. So this is about versions of Python. Next, installation of Python. I think the maximum students are working with their mobiles. So Python is having option. You can implement Python application with the help of your mobile also. So no need to bother about that one. So I don't have PC or I don't have laptop to work or to practice Python. You no need to bother about that one. With the help of mobile also, you can practice your Python. Not only practicing, if you want, you can implement applications also. So generally, to install the Python, so when it comes to macOS or Linux, some operating systems, by default, they came with Python. By default, they came with Python. But Windows operating system, we don't have. So we need to install from python.org website. And if you want to check that, if you want to check that, whether my system is having Python or not, with the help of this command prompt, we can work. So just go with command prompt. For example, so I'm going to command prompt by typing cmd. So by typing cmd, I entered into command prompt. So here, to check whether your software, your Python is there or not, just python hyphen hyphen version. So if you type python hyphen hyphen version, then we can get Python version. In my system, I'm having Python 3.5.2. So I'm not a developer, that's why I'm having old version. If you require, you can go with latest version also. Okay, so this is a way to check whether my system is having Python or not. If your system doesn't have Python, then you need to download it, download the software from python.org website. So I will show you how to download Python software. So I will show you how to. So just open the website. So python.org. Here in python.org website, we can find downloads. So in downloads, you can get the latest version. Python 3.8.2 is there, but I will give the preference. I will prefer Python 3.7. So if you want to go with all versions, just click on all releases. Here we can find different versions. So here we are having. So choose 3.7.0 and click on download. So we can find different versions, but go with 3.7 only. 3.7. It is released in June 27, 2018. So click on download and you can get downloadable link. And one more thing is, if you want to learn different types of softwares, compulsorily you need to purchase the textbooks and you need to learn the things. But in Python, we are having community. Python community is there. So here we can learn everything. What are the advantages? What are the future implementations are there? And what's the difference with the earlier versions? And what are the features they added? Everything we can go. Here they can provide documents also. So here you said that what's the new in Python 3.8. For example, I am working with Python 3.7. So if I want to go with 3.8, so before going, I should know what are the new features it is having. So here we can get it. So everything we can get through python.org website. And the people who are working with mobiles, so they require some software which is available on Play Store. So I'm having one video, I will explain about that one. Are you getting my screen?
So
now I'm playing one video. Are you getting?
Yes sir.
Video is playing now?
Yes sir.
Okay. Thank you. So, if you want to work with your mobile, so we are having one software called QPython. With the help of that QPython, we can work Python application in your mobile. So go to Play Store and here we can search QPython 3. So why? Because now we are working with Python 3 version onwards. So here you can get QPython 3L. So just to click on install to get the installation process. So it is going to install. Once it is installed, then just to click on open, it will open. So it will ask something. So here, this QPython is having this home screen. So console, editor, programs, QPyPI community. So now we discuss about what is meant by console. So when you click on console, you will get this one. So this is Python console. So this Python console is help to you to work with Python commands. So if maximum Python is having list of commands. So if you want to work with these commands, so here in Python console, you can work. Just here you may find 3 greater than symbols. Here you need to type the command. So whatever you type the command, after completion of your command, just to press enter. So for example, here I'm typing some print So I typed print welcome to Python. So after completion of just press enter. So once you typed any command, after completion of that one, please press enter. Once you press enter, then it will execute. So just to say that when I click print welcome to Python, so I got welcome to Python. So here you no need to keep any semicolons or anything, just to press enter, that's all. So print is a command to display the message on monitor. So what I did here, print, I opened the bracket, within double quotations I mentioned welcome to Python. So this is about Python console. And if you want to close the console, in top corner here is there, just to click on close. And next, editor is there. So if you want to work with coding, more lines of coding, if I want to go with one programming, then you can go with editor. So here we can type more than one line. So here I'm taking the same example to print the message. Just I typed print welcome. After typing that one, so here we can find some controls. So we are having different type of controls we don't require. So this is save button. So when you click on this button, it will save the program. And this is execute button. Once you saved the program, when you click on this button, it will execute your application. So here I am clicking save. Once I click it save, I got this one. So here you need to type your program. After typing your program name, click on tick mark. So Python application is having extension .py. So you need to mention the program file name with extension. Okay, so here I mentioned prog1.py. So I saved the program. When I clicked on this one, it will execute it. So welcome, it is executing. So I closed that one. And if I want to close this one, next, programs. So it is having some list of sample applications. If you want to execute, you can execute these all things. And projects also there. So sample projects and sample applications are there. If you want to work, you can work with that one. And QPYPI. So just I said that with the help of Python, you can work with machine learning applications, or else you can work with games, or else you can work with web applications, like that I said. So these all things are possible with additional libraries. So I installed only Python. QPython means I installed only Python. So basic Python applications, everything you go through on this one. So now if I want to work with machine learning, or else if I want to work with some other software, so you require additional libraries. That additional libraries you can install with the help of QPYPI. So here we are having two options, install with QPYPI and install with official PyPI. So generally this QPython 3 app having some list of predefined libraries. So when you click on this one, when you click on this button, we can get list of pre libraries. So these are the list of pre libraries, but these are not yet installed. These are the libraries which are available to support with QPython, but these are not yet installed. If you want to install, just to click on particular package, then the installation will start. So it will come like this, just to click on install with QPI, then installation will start. So for this installation, you require internet also. So without net, it is not possible. And next one is pip console. So for example, myself only, I implemented one library. Or else someone implemented library which supports with QPython 3. So, but it was not listed. Then you can install by yourself with the help of QPyPy. Okay, so this is about QPython.